this video, we're going to learn how to use a program called Seesaw. It's possible that your teacher has already shared the direct link with you to Seesaw, but if they haven't, all you need to do is search for Seesaw in the search bar, click on the first link that pops up, and that will take you directly to Seesaw. From there, go ahead and click on Login. Since you're a student, you're going to go ahead and click I'm a student. Here you'll have some different options for how you can sign in. If you have a Google email through your school, you can sign in with Google. Or if you've previously signed in with another email and password, you can enter that below. If you have a Clever single sign-in login, you can click the link here to log in with Clever. And if your teacher gave you a code to enter, you can enter it in the text code box, or you can scan a QR code to get yourself into Seesaw. So here I'll just enter a code that my teacher gave and click go. Then you'll need to find your name and click on it. It will ask you if you want to sign in and click the green check. Once you're in Seesaw, you're going to see the assignments that your teacher has assigned to you on the left-hand side of the screen. You'll notice that these are in the waiting for response section, which means that your teacher is waiting for you to complete this assignment. So let's scroll down and take a look at this assignment here. Curious moment, what can you create to see how we can complete it? In order to access the assignment, I'm going to click on it, and then you'll notice that there's a set of instructions. In addition to reading the instructions, you can also play the instructions out loud so that they are read to you. After you've read or listened to the instructions and you're ready to complete the assignment, go down to Add Response. You'll notice at the top that you can also access the instructions again if you need to, and you can also listen to them being read out loud to you. So for each assignment, your teacher will tell you how they want you to respond, and in general, you have 6 choices. The first option is to take a photo of your work. Here you can select Photo, and then you can hold your work up to your webcam and take a picture of it. Once you've taken a picture of your work, you'll notice that you have several options for how you can annotate on top of it. For example, you could add text. So I might say, my awesome portfolio. And then if you needed to, you could rotate how that text box shows up. You can also drag the corner to make it smaller or bigger. And you can also customize the style, alignment, and color of the text. In this case, your teacher wants you to explain the assignment that you're showing. Here, you'll select microphone, click allow to give it access to your microphone, then you can start recording. This is my awesome portfolio. I can't wait to show it to you. When you're ready, click done, and you'll see that an audio file has been added to your assignment. If you listen to it and don't like it and want to redo, just click on the 3 dots below and click delete, and that will get rid of that audio file. Next, you could add another picture through your webcam. We already looked at that, so I'm not going to show you that again. And if you want to further customize it, you also have options for shapes that you can add. So for example, you might want to add things like arrows that point to specific parts of your work. The shapes are fully customizable, so you can drag them wherever you want them to go, as well as adjust the size, and you can also adjust the way that the shapes look. Then at the bottom, if you click on the caption, that will allow you to add an explanation of what you're showing if you need to add that as well for your teacher. And at the bottom, you'll see different tools like a pencil, pen, highlighter, and marker that will allow you to draw directly onto this image. The colors are fully customizable, and if you don't like what you did, you can go to the eraser tool to erase what you wrote. In addition to the eraser tool, there's also an undo and redo button. So if you just want to undo something to get back to a previous version, you would click on that button and you'll see that it looks the way that it did before. Once you're ready to hand the assignment in, go to the green check at the top, and depending on your teacher's settings, it might tell you that your work is still waiting for teacher approval. It's possible that your teacher might not accept your work and might request that you redo it, in which case you'll be able to edit it again to be able to fix any errors. Once you fix them, you can resubmit your work, and again, it will be waiting for teacher approval. Once your work has been approved, it will show up in your journal. And as you continue to add work, you'll be able to see all the assignments that you added on your journal page. Let's go back to the activities for a moment to look at this other assignment that you need to complete. Here you'll notice that your teacher has actually given you a worksheet that you need to draw on top of in order to solve these problems. It looks like your teacher did the first problem for you here. So in this case, you would just use the drawing tools in order to solve the problems, and then after you've solved them, go up to the green check again to submit it. Now that we've learned how to add an image with annotations to our journals, as well as how to complete work directly on top of a worksheet that our teacher gives to us, let's just look briefly at a couple of the other ways that we can add assignments to our journal. So if we go back to the green Add button, you'll also see that you have an option to add a video. Video will just take a video from your web camera in the same way that we took a photo. So here you could actually record a video of yourself talking about your work, and then you could submit that to your teacher. Once you're done with that video, go up to the green check, then you'll be able to listen to that video again and use all the same annotation tools as you did with the picture. Another option is to upload a file. These files could come from either your computer or from your Google Drive. You can also add a note to complete an assignment, so this would be a little bit more like writing directly onto a piece of paper. You could also include a link to another website. Lastly, let's look at where you can see announcements that your teacher has made. You'll notice next to the inbox that it's telling us that we have unread messages. When you click on inbox and then click on the messages tab, you can see any messages that your teacher has sent you. And then when you click on the notifications tab, you can see if your teacher provided you with any feedback on your work, as well as whether or not your teacher approved your work to go into your journal. There's a lot you can do with Seesaw, and those are really just the basics, but it's a great program for you to be able to show your teacher exactly what you're learning.